welcome to Hillheads for this game between the Whitley Bay Beacons and the Telford Wrekin Raiders. Telford arrive here very much in the mix for the promotion playoff, as they're currently third, but a win here today should take them above Leeds, who lost at home to Caledonia last night. Congratulations to Caledonia, who were confirmed as league champions. I think it was only a matter of time before that was confirmed anyway, but obviously with that championship comes one of the playoff places, and so second spot is still up for grabs, and it has been a very tight battle all season between the Leeds Roses and the Telford Wrekin Raiders. Telford come here hoping to do something they haven't achieved before, and that's to win here at Hillheads. They've lost on both their previous two visits, so let's see what they can do today. But as for the Beacons, well, it's a pretty strong lineup themselves. They're going to go with a top line of Captain Joy Hurst, Iona Harrison and Georgia Wilkinson. But there's been a few players recalled and back from injury or unavailability. So Paige Brooks is a welcomed addition, as is Jane Skelton. And a player who is making her debut was on defence, number 17, Emily Duffy, who's stepped up from the Beacons under-16s teams, as she is now old enough to play senior hockey. And in goal, Jade Yip is unavailable, so a debut for Lindsay Zorbin-Young, who comes in from the Cleveland Comet. So best of luck to Lindsay on her senior women's debut, as the officials are just making sure the net is ready. A slight delay then before we get the opening puck drop. But it's usually the goal at the other end that doesn't fit flush to the ice. And we're underway then, finally. And on that far side, Beacons carry in with Georgia Wilkinson. Grabbed by Iona Harrison, sends it rink wide. Joy Hurst will come across. Isabel Johnson thought about pinching in. Her usual D partner isn't here, Megan MacArthur, so she's partnering Caitlin Eastwood. In the corner comes loose. Georgia Wilkinson comes in, closes down the puck handling. It's back with Telford, who will slowly build as they carry out from their own zone here and into the offensive zone on that far side. Picked off by Iona Harrison. It's cleared. Comes out the zone. Collected on the far side by Telford. And make one or two changes early on. One of the younger players on the team, Hayley Batsford-Carrington, who's wearing the number 96 jersey. She's on the ice now, paired with Maddie Madziak, who is American-born player, I believe, or Canadian even, and a fantastic player. Scores a lot of points for the Raiders. Picked off by Iona Harrison. It's a long shift for her. She does finally go back to the bench. Paige Brooks chases down, just unable to keep it in on the far side, but good work there by Georgia Wilkinson, who again has not come off the ice yet. The wind is howling outside. I can hear it whistling through the corridors of this old rink. Collected by Alex Browell. Now, Beacons will clear. Collected by Gledhill. He's got time to play it forward to Baxter Carrington. Lisa Eden picks off, finds Alex Browell, and enter Paige Brooks just out of her reach. She will have to readjust in front of the Beacons bench, but puck comes loose and fresh off the bench is Letitia Liu, who has been a new signing this season and has been a welcomed addition as well. She's a very talented player. Beacons looking to get the breakout there with Tanya Royce, but well kept in on the far side. And the Raiders crack home their first then. That early pressure camped in the Beacon zone pays off. And I think it was Karen Gregory who did such a good job of keeping the puck inside the zone initially, but Letitia Liu then getting her first of the game. And it's a 1-0 lead then to the promotion chasers. And McLean with the draw. It's Letitia Liu who has possession now. Carried in by Nicola Wallace. Deacon's trying to steal it back. Claire Wilson, who's doing a good job there defensively. She's the centre on this line, but playing pretty deep right now. It's carried out nicely by Emily Duffy. She's showing a lot of confidence for a young player. Great to see him, and great to see her making her senior debut. Dug out the corner on the far side. Looked around by Zoe Wallace on the far side, wearing number 27. Nice little pass there by Susie Rutherford. Claire Wilson will chase after it, but cover will clear. Collected by Rutherford once again. She fires back in. Beacons are in an offside position. We'll have to retreat. That gives Telford a time to get set and carry up the ice. Heather Metcalf, one of the more senior players on the team. Collects at centre red. She will drag back and carry into the offensive zone. Nice little poke check there by Iona Harrison, just doing enough to clear it outside the zone. Telford retreat but regain at centre red. Iona steals back but then put under pressure instantly by Metcalf. Iona has it again. Oh, lovely little turn of direction there, and again gets inside the second player and then evades a third challenge. But actually that vital interception there, I think it was Miller who did just enough to take the puck off her, puck come loose, and one of her teammates was able to regather. Georgia carries in on the far side. Certainly added more goals and points to her production this season. Fantastic player. But say one thing missing last season was points, and she's really addressed that this year as her development continues to improve and grow each week. And there she is again. She's lost her stick there. I think that's saying that should be a penalty, and it is. Yeah, going to be slashing because they did force the stick out of her hands. And so the Beacons will go on the power play. Just over 5 minutes played here then. 1-0 Telford. Of the Beacons going on the power play. Face off on the far side then. Iona wins it just about, gets it back to the point. Then to Isabel Johnson, who has to adjust pretty quickly, but did well with Madziak closing in on her. Flies one in. Oh, that's a fantastic goal by Johnson. That was almost like a golfer's chip into the top corner. And with Michelle Madziak closing in on her, she was put under a lot of pressure and she had to put a lot of height on the effort, and it chipped into that top corner. It was an intricate finish, but a fantastic one, and she's just got her team back level. So 1-1 here then at Hillheads. Carried up on this near side. Blue, who got the goal for Telford, looking to get a second there. Comes in, shot through traffic, up from Gledhill. It's absorbed and cleared. Comes back, Gledhill's got time to gather in with Zoe Bastien-Gillett closing in again. She's only about her third or fourth game for the Beacons, but already you're seeing massive improvement from when she started, and it's great to see another player who's joined mid-season. Alex Browell over on that far side, banks off the boards, keeps it inside once again and fires in, collected by Gledhill behind the net. Cox is open as an option. We'll find her. She'll play it forward. McLean even will close it down, but Alex Brell gets there first. She will clear. Rowan Allen goes towards the boards and will steal it back from Karen Gregory on that far side. Cox can't quite clear it. Miller will, only as far as Alex Brell, as Tanya Royce is slow to get up there. A bit frustration there, I think. Gets it back, then lays it off to Lisa Eden. Tanya again works it out wide. Rachel Logan works it clear, and then played forward by Tanya Royce. A bit of a shrug from her there. I think she realised it wasn't what she quite wanted there. It was maybe put a little bit too much on the pass, but Beacon's now having to defend as the shot comes in. It was a fiercely driven effort there by Telford. Good save by Lindsay. And again, smothers it well. Cleared out. Oh, and it takes a weird bounce as Telford were looking to keep it in, but that's allowed Claire Wilson to break in, but Telford just getting back. Claire will gather off the boards. Breakaway not quite able to come off there, but did well to get in. And now they're in on goal. Oh, fires wide. It was Heather Metcalf with that effort, just that's wide of a goal. But Lindsay making herself big there and forcing the shooter wide. Claire doing well on that far side. Again, only made her debut on the turn of the year, and she became old enough to play for the seniors. And that one's caught up along the goal frame. Lindsay will just cover that one up, and which will get a face-off in the Beacon zone. Iona Harrison's line is back out there. By Georgia Wilkinson. She banks it off the boards. Iona Harrison, look at the pace on her there. Steals in, and then Telford getting people back there to defend. Puck comes back through. It's out of Iona's reach as she was getting back up under her feet. Nice pass forward though by Telford. Threaded perfectly into the path of Heather Metcalf, who got a shot. Sorry, Madziak even, who got her shot off. Comes back loose. Michelle Madziak will regain possession. She's a busy player at both ends of the ice. Similar to Iona in many ways as she's looking to wind up another surge forward. Splits past two Telford players there. Gets a shot on that shot. A shoot through the legs there of Donna Sumnell. Joy Hurst collects. Nice drag back. Tried to go short side, but it's gathered in by Alice Summerford. Alice, who's played for the Beacons under-16s last season, helping us out a couple of times when we've needed players. Face off on the far side. Tanya Royce will take the draw. That's in the corner. Worked back to Wallace. Forward, I should say. Nicola Wallace, because there's two Wallaces on the team. Letitia Liu looking to get the shot off. Blocked by Lisa Eden, though, who's did a good job of sticking with her there. And then she tries to fire at an almost impossible angle there. Lindsay had it covered on that blocker side. Juan Allen just out of her reach. It's fired back in by the Raiders. And McLean in the corner works it back, and eventually it's cleared. Some good work by Rowan Allen. Persistence there, getting it away. Alex Brow will collect. Sends it around the boards. It will come around for Rowan Allen, but she's closed in pretty quick. She had to play it, and then helped out somewhat there by Tanya Royce, who's clattered on the way through. Pucks back off the boards. Collected by Letitia Liu. Nice little drag pack to take it past Rowan Allen, and then the same way past Tanya Royce. Alex Brough comes across, so she was having none of it, and she cleared it and protected her crease. Nice little pass forward, just dropped in front of Tanya Royce. Jen Skelton has to delay before carrying in. And Emily Duffy coming in on that far side. Again, certainly not looked overawed, the youngster who's made her senior debut. As this season's gone on, or to give away beyond the back of a net, but it's well poked clear by Lindsay. Again, just clearing the puck. I think Beacon's had enough bodies back there to deal with it. But yeah, as the season's gone on, plenty of new players have joined, which is great to see, and bodes well for next season as Claire Wilson carries in, works it back to Jane Skelton, who's been a great leadership figure, both from a coaching perspective on the bench, but also on the ice as well. And her points production has been fantastic this season. Very much a player that a lot of these younger girls look up to, given the career she's had, and understandably so. Banked off the boards into the corner. Fierce cutback picked off by Claire Wilson. Michelle Madziak shrugs off one challenge, gets in behind, goes to the backhand. Nice poke check by Lindsay, and then again it comes through just as Hayley Bassford-Carrington was about to pull the trigger. Lindsay Corbin-Young there just able to get the stick on it to poke it away. This is a fantastic game of hockey actually in this opening 20 minutes. Madziak will duel it out with Iona Harrison, and it will fall for the Raiders to Zoe Wallace. Georgia Wilkinson just shoves her out the way as she clears. I've got that. Developing that physical side to the game as well. Great all-round player, Georgia. Say she's had a lot of experience of playing for the Newcastle Predators rec team, so she's coming up against older men who are sort of going to play a lot more physical hockey, so it's great to see her able to bring that to the game as well. Over on that far side is Zoe Wallace, who will collect off the boards. Georgia steals it back, finds Joy Hurst, who carries in. Joy readjusts herself, gets a shot off, but it will be saved by Alice Summerford, who will hold on. Alice, who said before, has played for the Beacon 16s last season. Very good young goalie with a bright future in the game. And even though they lost a very good goalie last year, Telford, been able to replace her with one equally as good, which is always a positive thing. Over on the far side, Anne McLean looking to break away. Nice defending though by Caitlin Eastwood, who just used her body to squeeze her against the boards and steal the puck off her. And that was very well taken there by Lindsay in the Beacon's net. Nice flick of a glove to carry in. Face-off end to be taken between Anne McLean and Tanya Royce, and it's the Beacons who just about win it, but Anne still got her shot off and forced a pad save out of Lindsay. Puck just creeping over the blue line, and the Beacons looking to push out. We get a whistle on the play. But say the action continuing at both ends of what is a pretty full section here in front of me and to my right. Great to see plenty of fans down here. Of course, the Warrior season has now ended, so hopefully that will bring a lot more hockey fans down to the rink over the next couple of months. Letitia Liu on the far side. Worked back, picked off by Rowan Allen, who took it around Letitia Liu there and did so very well. Glad Hill's clearance loops up, comes back off the top of the boards. Lou looking to get in behind Tanya Royce, but couldn't quite get towards goal. She'll cycle it back round. Fired in on net, flicked off the thumb, I think, of of the glove of Lindsay there, on the and then comes back loose. Oh, it's sent across the rink, or rink wide, I should say, as Lisa Eden looks to steal in, and then that will just roll its way out, and the Beacons can push out. Logan, I think it was, and then Heather Metcalf in possession now, takes it behind the back of the net. Will hold on and delay before getting a shot off, but there, nice work by Tanya Royce, who was back checking well there. Still with Metcalf. Can't seem to sugar off the puck. Oh, fell to a high slot, but unable to control it there. Connor Sumnell just out of their reach. Carried back in. Beacons will carry out then with Claire Wilson. Claire will collect her own rebound off the boards with 4.5 minutes to go in this opening period. It's still tied at one. Puck comes out. Susie Rutherford will battle and as well guns it back for Claire. Never quit on the play there. Susie just stuck with it and prevented the Telford player from stealing in. Miller on the far side. Floats one across, picked off by the Beacons and Emily Duffy. Good play from her. Winds one up and almost scores there. Just flash wide of a post, but a very quick release on that shot. Got a lot of power behind it, and as I say, I didn't miss by much. That would have been a fantastic way to mark a debut as Joy Hurst goes short side, hits the outside of a goal frame, tried to go top shelf, block aside. Beacons are warming up here and growing into the game. Puck just falling behind. Let's quite see who it was, but Madziak's in here. Gave a little dummy there, a bit of a shimmy as she raced down the low slot to fool Lindsay, but got the shot off and finished well with a breakaway. And just as the Beacons were applying the pressure, it got caught on the break, but Telford regained the lead and a fantastic finish by Michelle Madziak. Poked away by Iona Harrison, out wide to Georgia Wilkinson, who gets it behind Madziak and will chase after it. 3:15 to go in this opening period, and when Telford reasserting themselves with a 2-1 lead as Joy Hurst goes for a one-timer, just swept it wide of the goal, though, but again, didn't miss by much. Beacons probably unfortunate to be behind right now, as they soaked up a lot of pressure early on, but the last couple of minutes, just prior to Telford retaking the lead, they had some chances of their own. Madziak forces the puck into the offensive zone before going for the change. Still with the Raiders. Batsford in quite control as the Beacons will push out, and Caitlin Eastwood, who's up there with Joy Hurst, and she finds it 2-0, it's just out of her reach. Tried to feed Georgia Wilkinson on the far side as well, but again the Beacons creating a good scoring opportunity there. They could have easily have had 3 more goals in these last couple of minutes. Tried to squeeze home on that near side, attempted wraparound from Georgia Wilkinson, but Alice Summerford will cover up. And we'll get an offensive zone face-off for the Beacons with a little over 2 minutes remaining in this first period. 2-1 Raiders. Iona Harrison with the draw. Puck rolls along the top of the boards and comes back out. Comes from Letitia Liu once again, just fired over the top of the goal frame. Shot through traffic, it's charged down and comes back out wide, but Liu is the first one to it. Sends it through the crease, but then Lindsay will gather it in, uses a stick just to bring it back into her reach. She'll cover up and we'll get a defensive zone face-off for the Beacons. Allows both sides to make some personnel changes here then. Miller fires, took a deflection off Paige Brooks' stick. Redirected it slightly, might even have took a bit of power out of it, but either way, Lindsay covered up and we will go again. Beacons, ooh, just about win that one, just out of Paige's reach, it was behind her. Alex Browell sends it across. Anya Royce clears, a puck will come out of the zone. Miller now looking to carry back in, fires in towards net. It was a bounce slightly a couple of times and Lindsay had to readjust herself, just to readjust her feet there to get it away, and then helped out by Alex Browell, who carries away from danger. But Telford doing a good job of keeping the pressure on in the zone. And that was finished well there by Heather Metcalf, who was left all alone in the low slot, had time to pick a spot and fired it home with just inside the final minute. So a 3-1 lead to Telford. Back underway then. Telford will control behind their own net. Carried out nicely by Erin Tipton. Oh, she's going to go coast to coast here, but good work from Tanya Royce and Islay Northen there to break the play up. But just riding up over a stick of Barbara McInnes there. Tanya Royce, she cuts through the neutral zone into the offensive zone. I think maybe player might have just been offside on the far side. I think official was pointing to Rowan Allen, who was at the top of the screen there. I think she might have just strayed offside. We'll serve 11 seconds to go then, and we'll get a face-off outside of the Telford zone. Officials can't quite make up their mind which side of the rink they want it to take place on, which I believe it should be on the side where the incident took place, which is where they are now, so that is correct. Madziak sends it off the boards there, comes back through for Susie Rutherford, but Beacons again being put under pressure here. Becky Craig on the far side, who cuts down that left wing. But that will do it then for the first period. Telford with a 3-1 lead. At times they've looked like they deserve that lead, but Beacons have created a lot of goal scoring opportunities themselves, and so perhaps can feel a little bit aggrieved that they are not level. But either way, Telford with a 3-1 lead, and they've looked good throughout. Welcome back then to Hillheads, as it's carnival time here. There's a lot of dancing going on, especially from the Telford bench. And, well, they're probably in a good position to be enjoying life right now, having given themselves a two-goal lead right at the end of the period. So a lot of pressure early on, which the Beacons had soaked up, but I'd say Telford maybe getting their just rewards there towards the end of that period. But as I say, a couple of minutes before that, the Beacons had at least three good goal-scoring opportunities and were unlucky not to have taken at least one or two of them. So back underway then, and Letitia Liu will carry in. Going Skelton doing a good job of trying to tie her up as the puck loops over the top of the goal. Caitlin Eastwood will gather. Puck comes out the zone. Zoe Wallace controls. Up along this near side, it's Shannon Griffiths wearing the number 35. Kerry Dunn jersey. Controlled by Liu. Got the puck just sticking on it. And then the puck comes back to her as Claire Wilson tries to carry out. Caitlin Eastwood doing a good job on the forecheck there, putting her under pressure. Still with Liu. Nice poke check there by Isabel Johnson. Those two at the back for the Beacons, Eastwood and Johnson, have got a good understanding. When one goes forward, the other one stays back and becomes a stay-at-home defender. But between them, they've got it worked out well. And say both are going to have a bright future in the game. And you would think in a couple of years will be part of the Elite League team. If their rate of development continues, puck rolling along the top of the boards and falls nicely for Jane Skelton. Couldn't quite get it out the zone though, as Telford will keep it inside. Okay, Lanise will pushing out once again, doing a great job there. Three against one, but she's battling well and easing the pressure on her own team's goal. Jane Skelton will keep inside. Brought down, no call. She perhaps felt that she might have been impeded there, but it just seemed to just be squeezed along the boards, which generally is accepted. Zoe Wallace clears. Telford looking to build once again. Iona Harrison brings down the play on the far side. But again, no call. Shot's blocked. Georgia Wilkinson works it back to Iona. Gets some space, fires, good save by Alice, and then a second save, attempted wraparound. Iona not giving up on that play. She was determined to get that puck home, but didn't quite happen for her. And then Georgia Wilkinson working hard as the puck comes back out. It's going to be Islay Northend who will get there first. Shot through traffic, just wide. Miller there is. She gets a shot off and then I think collides with Iona Harrison on the way through there. Puck comes back off the boards. Iona will break through the Telford D there, gets back onto our forehand, gets a shot off, but forces Alice Summerford into a save and she'll hold on. Tanya Royce to take the draw then. The officials want it retaken. Tanya Royce trying to get on the end of that one. Rowan Allen will work it back. Tanya fires, rig. Rebound and then swatted away by Alice Summerford there. Madziak breaks in, gets in behind the D, but Lindsay did a good job of forcing it wide. Took the shooting opportunity away from her once again. Madziak again, good shot, big rebound. It's a scramble and then bodies flying around all over the place there, but officials, I think, had already made the blown the whistle by that point. But we'll keep the face-off inside the Beacon zone then. Shot comes through, cleared away by Lindsay. And then big rebound, but Anne McLean couldn't get the shot off. I think she tried to take it on the backhand and then I just allowed Susie Rutherford to come across and get it away. Still in possession here, Susie Puck just sticking on her though. Puck comes back to a point and Gledhill fires. It took a deflection off, I think, off someone's stick initially and maybe even rode off the top of someone's helmet as well. Jane Skelton trying to carry that one or chase that one down into the offensive zone. Lovely little flick there behind her for Susie Rutherford. Deacon's trying to carry out on the far side, Emily Duffy, but just outnumbered on that far side. Claire Wilson will carry through the neutral zone into the offensive zone, gets in behind, gets a shot off. But I think Michelle Madziak maybe just got a piece of that and just did enough to put her off and get the puck to go wide. Jane Skelton couldn't quite find her intended target of Claire Wilson, and now they look to pick the Beacons off on the break once again. Lou fires wide. Lindsay did great there to force her wide, very aggressive coming off her line there. She had to be, really. And Skelton releases Emily Duffy and carries through into offensive zone once again. Shots just behind the goal, but did well charging up from the back there. It's end-to-end stuff. It's almost like a tennis match here as one team serves and the other. Eastwood sends it in. Gledhill will collect between the hash marks. Isabel Johnson does well to get there just ahead of Letitia Liu. And now she'll carry forward. She's already scored one spectacular goal today. Can she get another? Gets a shot on net. Forces the save out of Alice Summerford and then collision at the end there. So, face-off in the Telford zone then, with about 6.5 minutes played here at the start of the second period. It's 3-1 Raiders. Iona Harrison wins a draw, but Telford quickly regain possession. Puck comes back out. Georgia Wilkinson sends it forward. Iona Harrison works it back. Shot on the turn there by Joy Hurst, and it's almost put home, but Georgia Wilkinson robbed by Alice Summerford there. She thought it was a certain goal, I think, Georgia. She was frustration at the end as she'd been robbed. But we shall go again, and Iona will take the draw once again in that same position. Zoe Wallace controls. Over to Joy Hurst, picked off by the Raiders. And as far as Lisa Eden, who sends one back through, but again, player making the challenge on a Sumnall. Did enough just to direct it away. Another shot comes in from Georgia Wilkinson. Alice has faced a lot of rubber early in this first half of the game, and Beacon's not afraid to shoot on sight. testing their resolve. Buck up along these near boards. Georgia Wilkinson in there, along with Lisa Eden, trying to work it free, and then Zoe Wallace will stab it along the boards. Collected by Lisa Eden, helped on its way by Georgia Wilkinson. Puck comes out, gathered by Sumner. Out of the reach of Joy Hurst, over on that far side, sent around the boards. McInnes keeps it inside. McLean playing the puck out wide. Lisa Eden's got time to clear. Rowan Allen looking to control and get the break on, and she will do so as she sends it through the defender's legs and then gets a shot off. I think it was Heather Metcalf who might have been back there. But lovely little pass as she threaded it through with her opponent's legs and then, say, just shot wide of the goal, but it was a good effort. It was always going to take a something special to beat Alice Summerford from that area, but she tried it all the same. Telford will control. Madziak, but coming loose. Eastwood's onto it straight away, sends it into the corner, and will chase it down. Through over onto his near side. Off the boards, comes back through. That'll be an ice and cool low on the Raiders. So 10:40 to go in the second period, approaching the midpoint of the game. 3-1 lead to the Raiders. Face off on the far side. Claire Wilson will take it against Michelle Madziak. Puck comes loose. It will come out the zone. Susie Rutherford across to Islay. Puck comes back off the end boards. Jane Skelton. Controlled on that far side. Claire Wilson. Working the puck back. Gathered by Telford, who sends it around the boards. McLean into the path there of Heather Metcalf, I think it is. Didn't quite see the numbers. Miller sends it towards goal. Took a nick off Claire Wilson's stick, I think off the heel of her stick. But Lindsay was able to make the save all the same. We are past the midpoint of the game then. 9:50 to go in this second period. Well won by Fiona Harrison. It was a fierce draw. To Eden, sends it back the other way. Puck just sitting loose there, just behind Georgia Wilkinson. It'll be gathered by Iona Harrison, who controls from behind the back of the goal. Joy Hurst into a path of Wilkinson. It's cleared away, though, by Karen Gregory, the number 20 for Telford. Still with Joy Hurst. Her shot's blocked. Charged down, and Telford now looking to break out. Over on the far side, it's Telford who will control, but Iona Harrison coming in. Tisha Liu. Iona Harrison coming in, and Alex Brow keeps it inside. Fires from the point, comes back off the boards and controlled by Clara Gledhill. sent back through towards Iona Harrison. It was just behind her though. She was sort of spinning as she tried to control on the turn. Back in the corner, sent around the boards. Alex Brell. She now has to track back. Puck just getting past her. Letitia Liu. Work back to Miller. Saved well though by Lindsay. Comes back out. Kept inside by Madziak. Shoots through traffic. Big save though. As Lindsay saw that one late. Two or three bodies in front of her. So she did well to just get herself behind that one and make the stop. Meekins can push out. Meekins delaying Telford's entry into the offensive zone, but then shot loops up, I think, for Madziak there. Isabel Johnson, puck just getting behind her, around the back of the net. That's a Madziak once again, but cleared well by Zoe Bastian Gillick. Rowan Allen. Used off the puck there by some good defending by Telford. Zoe Wallace. Sends it off the boards with Rowan Allen putting in the pressure. Rowan goes with her. They collide in the corner. Puck comes back through. It's dealt with though by Alice Summerford. Well, Johnson couldn't quite gather, but then Telford will advance on this near side with Becky Craig, the number 17. Caitlin Eastwood over on that far side. Using a bit of pace to get in behind there. Needed some support. Rowan Allen was there, but outnumbered there as Telford had bodies back. Comes back across. Isabel Johnson clears, comes back off the Zamboni entrance boards. Nice work by Claire Wilson. Gets a shooting opportunity, fires from the high slot and hit Alice Summerford quite high up there, but dealt with it with just over 5.5 minutes to go in the period. It's still 3-1 Telford. Collected by Emily Duffy. Oh, nicely done there. Tried to take it around Nicola Wallace, I think it was, initially, but then just got outnumbered there in the neutral zone, but we'll get a stoppage anyway. Claire Wilson over on that far side will enter the zone. Finds Jane Skelton, but again, eased off the hook by the Telford defence. Islay Northend sends the puck back towards Claire Wilson in turn forward to Jane Skelton. It's picked off by Michelle Madziak though. Squeeze along the boards there as Letitia Liu once again surges forward. Needs some support though. She's outnumbered by the Beacon's defence there. Try to go short side, but well defended there by Emily Duffy. Barbara McInnes doing a good job of keeping the puck inside the zone. Works back. Fired from the high slot. Well, right from the point, rather. Good save once again by Lindsay, who covered off that near side, blocker side, sorry, glove side even. Claire Wilson will gather and break out. She'll have to go it alone, no, two against one here. If she loses an edge. Alex Brell keeps the puck inside the zone, and Telford will blast it clear. Icing's waved off. Picked off by Joy Hurst, but Metcalf's there to crash home, and Joy Hurst thought she'd just done enough there. I did as well. I thought she'd killed that play, but puck just falling kindly. I think that might have been Donna Sumner, actually. I didn't quite see who put the puck in. My initial thoughts was it was Heather Metcalf. Apologies, we'll have to get back to you on that one. Georgia Wilkinson works it back. Isabel Johnson out wide left. A little over 3 minutes remaining in the period. Now a 4-1 lead to Telford. Big collision along the boards there. Metcalf gets a shot off. It's almost steered home. On that far side by Hayley Batchard-Carrington. Back to Metcalf, fires. It flicked off the outside of Lindsay's blocker there and away. Puck sent through, but swept clear. Nicely done there by Isabel Johnson. Puck not quite coming out the zone. Now it will, as Joy Hurst is found on the left wing. Metcalf pokes it clear, gets it out the zone. Beacons will re-enter. Eastwood carries in. Sends one on net. Flicked away by Alice Summerford. Telford always having numbers back there. Defensively. Clara Gledhill there as well, able to get it away. A little over a minute and a half remaining in the period then, as Telford re-enter the offensive zone. Gledhill will collect, fires, and then covered up by Lindsay once again, who's I have to say, has made an impressive debut. Faced a lot of shots in this one. Michelle Madziak against Iona Harrison on the draw. Madziak controls. Still in the corner, but Beacons are going to get it away with Iona Harrison. Finds Rowan Allen, but Madziak quick to regain possession and will dump back in. Collected by Emily Duffy on the far side. Oh, nicely done there. She made sure the Telford player's momentum took her past her as she didn't rush the clearance. Still on it now. It was a nice pass across to Paige Brooks, although almost picked off there by Rebecca Cox. Letitia Liu looking to enter the zone, which she'll do now. Gets a shot off. Lindsay almost, I don't know if she did get a piece of it, maybe just come off her elbow or her arm of some description. Harrison's just been backdoored there. No call, though. I'm surprised that wasn't given. That was a pretty blatant penalty. Really, Paige Brooks asking why it wasn't called. But it's not been given, and we shall go into a break with a 4-1 lead to Telford. We'll have a 2-minute break, so please don't go anywhere. I said it would be a short one. We are back after a very short 2-minute break. We're doing all right for time though, so perhaps the girls could have had a little bit longer, but they seem keen to get on with it. 4-1 lead to Telford then. Iona Harrison's line will start for the Beacons. Heather Metcalf's line for the Raiders. As they have changed the line slightly, Letitia Liu is now on this line with Heather Metcalf. And Tiffany Jane Miller, I think, is on the far side as Iona's brought down. That's, she had her ankles taken away from her there. That's definitely going to be a penalty, and Mr. Emerson has got his arm raised. Just as, that's going to be a penalty shot. That's what I thought it would have to be. Thought it would have to be, really, given that she was in on goal like that. Alice Summerford raced back to the bench just as the whistle blew. Joy Hurst giving Iona a little bit of a chat there. Maybe one or two tips about what to do. It's not often you see penalty shots in the women's game. (Clears throat) As the music dies down then, Iona Harrison will take a long stride forward, collects the puck, goes straight down the runway, drifts to her left, fires, went early. Alice Summerford was right out to a perimeter of her crease there, made the shooting angle difficult. She is being mobbed by her teammates for making the save. But Iona opted to go early then, rather than duel it out. Seconds gone in the period then, already an interesting start to the final 20 minutes. Iona's going to stay out there as the ice pack's being sent towards the bench. Presumably someone's taken a knock. Joy Hurst fires. Alice will gather in though and hold on. As we go again, Iona to take the draw, wins, gets it back to Joy Hurst, cushions it back to Isabel Johnson, who fires through a couple of pairs of legs there. Georgia Wilkinson trying to set it back up to Iona in the low slot. Isabel stealing it back, but Michelle Madziak turns and gets it away. Amber Klein will collect off the boards, comes back to Joy Hurst, who plays in Iona Harris on the left wing, looks, winds one up, kick save, comes back out. It was a strong effort, drilled low by Iona. Georgia Wilkinson, puck just sticking on her there. The ice is going to be degrading somewhat now in the final period. Will be a bit more snow out there. I can see there's a couple of lumps just in front of the Beacon's bench. Banked off the boards. Zoe Wallace on the far side. There's Joy Hurst. Ushers it into the corner. She needs a bit more support there up from the back. Going it alone. And McLean couldn't gather. Tanya Royce will. Fires from the point. Michelle Madziak on that far side sends it around. Michelle again will collect on the left wing boards or come off Alex Browell's skate. Just had to check her movement there, but she went again. And now Becky Craig will take up the slack and carry in. Rowan Allen's quick there to steal the puck back. Comes back off the goal. Oh, Lindsay have lost sight of it. She went to go across onto a far side where she thought the puck was going, but that deflection fell perfectly. And then it was put home. And Telford now with a 5-1 lead. Rowan Allen on the far side dumps in. Beacons will look to chase after it, but it's back with Heather Metcalf on that far side. She fires. Lindsay takes that one high up in the chest and then helps to get it away into the corner. Comes back loose. Cleared by Zoe. Tanya Royce collects. Evades a couple of players. Rowan Allen trying to get in there. I think Clara Gledhill just got across in time. Was able to prevent the attack from happening. And then Beacons, who have flooded the offensive zone, I've just about stole it back. Good play by Zoe Bastian Gillick there. Out onto a far side. Delicate pass from Hayley Batchard Carrington. Doing enough to keep the puck going and keep the movement going as well as Nita Jalou fires. Lindsay dealt with it on her near side. Comes back to Hayley again, who was left alone in the mid-slot. Maybe didn't get enough power on it, but Lindsay dealt with it well all the same. Michelle Madziak on the far board, sends it around to Letitia Liu. Going with two of their most offensive weapons there. Oh, and she's drilled that one home, I think, on the blocker side there, Letitia Liu. And that makes it 6-1. But when you've got Michelle Madziak and Letitia Liu on the same line, they're going to cause many problems. Back underway then. Claire Wilson will charge down, wins it in fact, and shots blocked, comes back out the zone. Letitia Liu looking to get in behind Caitlin Eastwood, who's trying to stick with her. Some close defending there. Puck comes across, fired back in, or took a deflection. And I think it was Michelle Madziak with a goal. It fell fortunately for her because it hit her. And again, just fell right between her feet while Lindsay was looking for where the puck was intended to go and just allowed Michelle that time to slot home 7-1. So three quick goals then, really taking the game out of the Beacon's reach. Michelle Madziak tears after that one. She's found an extra gear in this third period. To Chalou. Claire Wilson doing well to steal it back though. Canadian born player. James Skelton in the corner, battling hard. Words of encouragement shouted from her daughter Poppy there from the stands, who's part of the Beacons under 16s team as well, which Jane coaches. Eastwood forward to Claire Wilson. Regathered. Cleared by Erin Tipton. Isabel Johnson sends it back inside the zone, which allows Joy Hurst to chase after. Just over 5 minutes played then at the start of his third and final period, and it's 7-1 Telford now. Anna Metcalf getting in behind, but shots blocked and puck's cleared, forcing Erin Tipton to retreat with the fast skating Beacons closing in on her. It was Isabel Johnson who was up from the bat there. Joy Hurst is across. Shot just sails through the crease. McLean. With Isabel Johnson assuring her up along the boards there. Doing a great job. Gonna whistle on the player, it's gonna be a penalty called. Must admit I didn't get a good view of that. It's gonna be for body checking, but I didn't get a good job of seeing it because it's right up along the boards. It's on Iona Harrison though. And it allows Telford to go on the power play for the first time in this game. I'm not happy with it. It seemed like the puck bounced when he dropped it. So I don't know if that was the reason why we got a retake. And we go again. Big rebound, another good save by Lindsay, who makes a double stop and then a third as she covers off the post on her blocker side. Gets back up and into position as Letitia Liu's pass is picked off by Claire Wilson. Controlled by Donna Sumnell. Claire Wilson again, who's been very good as an offensive spark in this game, looking to try and get things going for her team. Puck comes loose once again. Telford looking to capitalise here. Shot comes through. Good save did just enough to make the stop there. As Beacon's under a lot of pressure right now. Still on the penalty kill, there's just over a minute remaining of it. Well, this one certainly got the crowd pumped up, hasn't it? I seem to remember it from my early clubbing days. It's a combination of Greek plate smashing and hard house. But anyone who used to go clubbing in Whitley Bay in the late 90s, early noughties will remember that one, I'm sure. As Telford will regain in the corner. Whitley doing a good job here, making sure the puck stays high up the ice and win it back once again with some good work from Tanya Royce, who gets a return pass from Rowan Allen. Puck's cleared, only as far as Caitlin Eastwood, who collects at centre red. Plays into space to Allen once again, who carries in. Got time, gets back onto her backhand, poked away though by some good defending from Erin Tipton. Tanya Royce couldn't quite steer it on then after Alice Summerford had made a good save. Fresh out the box, Iona Harrison steals onto that one and stops the breakout. Gets onto her backhand, gets a shot off, kick save by Alice Summerford. Caitlin Eastwood sends the puck out and we'll find Joy Hurst. Letitia Liu will gather before the puck would settle. Iona Harrison will charge down. Erin Tipton gets in just behind her, but a bit of a push and shove going on there as they tangled off the puck. The defensive challenge by Caitlin Eastwood. Puck's back off the boards. Iona Harrison will dart back through, takes it inside. Tipton fires early and it wasn't off by much. She wound that one up. Still finding her range in this game, but so Letitia Liu gets in on goal. Kick save by Lindsay. She was falling off balance there. Did well just to stick her foot out and make the stop. Excellent save, in fact. Georgia Wilkinson. Again, the puck sticking on, I think, along them boards where a lot of the snow does mount up. The linesman just jumping out of the way of it. Good challenge by Iona to hack the puck clear from Miller. Into a corner. Beacons will find Georgia Wilkinson. She'll have the time to clear as we're inside the final 10 minutes of the game. Leadhill advances. Michelle Madziak. Paige Brooks controls. Diana Harrison, who's had a lot of ice time since coming back out of the box. She's appended. And it's going to be a Beacons power play then, as Iona did well there to make sure she got the penalty. And it's Hayley Batsford-Carrington who will go to the box. So Beacons back on the power play. They did ever so well actually to kill that penalty off before, considering at that time that Telford had scored three quick goals. So they were very much in the ascendancy. Back underway then. Little point. Caitlin Eastwood gets a return. Just behind Tanya Royce. That allows the Raiders to retreat. Oh, Caitlin Eastwood. Look. Just left it to the last second between her and Lindsay, whether she was going to cover it up, but Caitlin had the time to then start the breakout once again, and she'll have to delay as the Beacons get back onside. Rowan Allen collects on the left wing and ricochets up and hits Metcalf in the helmet, but still with Rowan Allen as she battles well down the left wing, sends it in on net. Shot coming in initially from Claire Wilson and a follow-up from Tanya Royce. Caitlin Eastwood just about kept it inside, but a vital poke check there from Anne McLean pushes it back out. Alex Brown will collect. Metcalf fans on it as Claire Wilson looks to steal in behind. Tanya Royce as well, she fans on it too, as Metcalf can then capitalise, takes it away from Caitlin Eastwood and will control down the left wing boards as their team make a couple of personnel changes. Eastwood will counter down the right wing side. Fires, deflected away. We have 30 seconds to go on this Beacons power play. Inside the final eight minutes of the game as Tanya Royce, I think it might have just come off the heel of her stick there as it flashed wide. Claire Wilson doing well, just parking herself in front of the crease. Collected on the blue line by Jane Skelton. Alex Brow was heading back to a bench though, so she didn't see the pass, and that will be the end of the power play event. Telford killing that one equally as well as the Beacons did before. Oh, and that one's gone top shelf from Michelle Madziak, who rifled that one home. I think Lindsay looked disappointed there, given her reaction, but not much you can do about it when they go top shelf like that. So 8-1 then, Telford. Not that it's particularly a way of measuring who is likely to finish second and third, but when Leeds came here, they were lucky to come away with a draw at the end, having been down 5-2 at one stage. Tidied up right at the end. That was as well with the Beacons going into penalty trouble late on, but Telford have looked, I think, more fired up for this one. I say they've never won here. Lost both games in the last couple of seasons. So this was a record they wanted to put straight, I'm sure. They came here last season right at the end when that controversial decision was made to gift the points to Widnes when the game was abandoned here early in the season. And that those points essentially ruled Telford out for mathematically overhauling Widnes at that stage. So I think there's despondency, disappointment. They come with a short bench as well, and that's maybe been the trouble in the past from Telford, is they've always been strong at home and will give anyone a tough game there, but often didn't travel with numbers. But they've certainly come with a strong bench today. Oh, fantastic save. Heather Metcalf well that one out. And saved fantastically well there by Lindsay Zorbin-Young, who plucked it out of mid-air. That looked a certain goal. Tanya Royce to take the draw against Metcalf. Comes back loose. Couldn't quite clear the zone. Metcalf shoots on the turn. Wide of the goal. Letitia Liu will collect. Very strong on the puck, works it back. Fired wide of the goal. On that far side, it's still with Telford. Rowan Allen with a vital poke chip there, trying to get it away. Metcalf digs it out the corner, will play it to Liu behind the back of the net. Just out of her reach though, so Bastian Gillick couldn't quite gather in, it was out of her reach, and it's fired back in by Telford. Puck again works loose, comes off the back of someone's skate, might have been Tanya Royce, but allows Lisa Eden to clear with 5.5 minutes remaining in the game. 8-1 Telford. And they're going to keep going as well, because, well, you never know, it might well come down to goal difference in the end. And if you can get a couple more goals, I'm sure they'll take them. But I think coming into a weekend, I believe Leeds did hold a one-point advantage. So if my maths are wrong, but the way I'll work it out now is Leeds lost yesterday at home to Caledonia, 6-4. It was a much closer game than I think a lot predicted, given the season that Caledonia have had. Oh, and that shot straight through the crease from James Skelton wasn't far off. And with this win for Telford, that should put them a point ahead. But off the top of my head, unfortunately, can't remember how many games each team have got left. But either way, it will be an advantage to Telford right now. Tanya Royce sent out wide. Jane Skelton. McLean. 4:04 remaining as Nicola Wallace sends one in on net. That's going to be saved though by Lindsay. She'll hold on. There's Leigh Northen going in there, offering some words of encouragement. Madziak going in for the draw against Claire Wilson. Shot straight from the draw is from Sumnall. It's cleared only as far as Hayley Batsford-Carrington. Claire Wilson will collect on the left wing. She takes it into the zone. Being forced wide though, good defending by Sumnall, showing her experience there against the youngster. Caitlin Eastwood gathers, sends it across to Isabel Johnson, takes it around Michelle Madziak. Sumnall gathers, oh, she doesn't actually, it's an air shot really, she swiped at it, that went under a stick. As Beacon's players upended, Claire Wilson it was, who ended up on the seat of her pants. Onto the far side, played out onto the left wing. Nice drop pass. Shot comes in. Oh, it was a laser beam finish there by Becky Craig, who drilled it into the bottom corner on the blocker side. 9-1 now Telford. And I said before about getting the goal difference up. That's certainly going to help. This has been a statement of intent from Telford, I think. They are hungry for that playoff place. As I say, after the disappointment of last season, you couldn't deny them it really, although Leeds are going to continue to push them close, I've got no doubt about that. It's become a very tight battle up at the top, and Sheffield aren't completely out of it as Letitia Liu gets in behind, fires and scores. Again, had time to pick a spot, went top shelf, and that is double figures. That is 10-1 with 2:43 remaining. Underway, just out of our reach of Letitia Liu. Puck enters the zone. Lisa Eden will chase after it. That's going to be called for icing. So that brings the face-off back into the offensive zone for Iona Harrison to take the face-off. Up against Heather Metcalf. Puck's worked along the boards. Still with the Beacons. We'll go short side. Good effort that by Emily Duffy, who, as I say, has impressed me on her debut. There'll be more to come from her this season, I'm sure. There's only a handful of games remaining, but this Beacon side have got to play Sheffield and Caledonia here before the end of May. They've got to go away to Telford in a few weeks as well, which I believe is their next game. Iona Harrison winds one up, fires. It's Alice Summerford who will cover it up as Joy Hurst was looking to try and get the rebound there, which she had every right to do. Nothing wrong with that. But I think Erin Tipton just making sure she didn't overstep the mark, which Joy wouldn't. She's not like that. As Tanya Royce will take the draw. Rutherford winds one up, floats it through, was dealt with the pads of Alice Summerford. Banked off the boards. So Alice has played a crucial role in this game. Again, it always sounds a bit daft when a team has exploded offensively like Telford have and put up 10 goals, but Alice, particularly early on in the first period, has made a lot of vital saves, which kept her side in it when it was still at 1-1 and indeed 2-1 when it was still relatively close. And Susie Rutherford, Rowan Allen will clear to Paige Brooks, who has time to lay off towards Emily Duffy just out of her reach, but will fall for Tanya Royce with a minute to go. Tanya carries in on the far side. It from behind the back of the net in Gretzky's office. Emily Duffy, that was again, who's got it well. Michelle Madziak's going to advance. That's a nice pass forward to Cox. They're saying it was offside. Ooh, it was close, but I think she might have entered the zone before. So, yeah, I think that probably was the correct call. Just under 40 seconds to go then. Face-off will take place just outside of the Beacon zone. Claire Wilson and Michelle Madziak to take the draw. Michelle wins it, works it back to the point. And Karen Gregory, well, I say the point, it was actually at centre red, but I'm sure you know what I mean. As Claire Wilson back to Jane Skelton. Oh, I sent it into space, that was a good idea. Shannon Griffiths unable to get there first, though, as Telford will work it back, but they'll look to get it away. As Beacons did still create a scoring opportunity there, with 5 seconds to go now. Carver Gledhill will get inside the D, but that will do it then. All a bit of pushing and shoving going on there at the end. Becky Craig, I think, just going over to tell her to calm down. That's her and I think it was Caitlin Eastwood who clashed there at the end, but seemed unnecessary at the end of a game like that. But tempers clearly boiling over. But anyway, a well-deserved 10-1 win for Telford. In terms of player of the game, I think for Telford, you couldn't deny that Michelle Madziak and Letitia Liu were very much at the heart of creating the offensive opportunities. But you'd also have to say Alice Summerford did a fantastic job in goal. I can see it going to any one of those three. I wouldn't like to make that decision, but Alice did keep her side in it at a crucial stage of the game, as I say, during that first period when it was tied at one for quite some time. Telford getting those two goals right late at the end of the period. For the Beacons, again, difficult day when it's you've seen so many goals conceded, but they battled hard, and the scoreline didn't perhaps reflect the effort that was put in. I would have to say Emily Duffy made a very impressive debut on D for a Beacon. She looks a bright player coming forward. I could see it going to her, but Isabel Johnson, not just from her goal, but I thought defensively as well, she put in a bit of a masterclass back there and did well getting forward at times. And you'd have to say well done as well to Lindsay Zorbin-Young, who I thought came in at the last minute, did a fantastic job, acquitted herself well, made some crucial saves, and I think without her, in that sort of form, it could have been probably double the scoreline, really. She made some fantastic saves, not least that one late on in the third period where she plucked it out of midair with her glove. And also I'd like to say Zoe Bastien-Gillick, who I think has come on leaps and bounds over the last few weeks, and good to see her improvement as that continues. But we shall see. We'll wait on air and bring you the outcome of those Player of the Game awards. So a 10-1 win then for the Telford Wrekin Raiders, who that should, as I say, take them up to second spot for the time being, and crucially that second playoff spot, which keeps them in line for promotion as well. Remember, promotion from Division 2 to Division 1 isn't decided until the winners are crowned at playoff finals weekend. So if Telford do finish second, they will face the winners of Division 2 South, which as it stands looks like being the Cardiff Comets, as they were last year. Caledonia, who are, I say, now crowned champions of this division, will play the second place team in Division 2 South, which at the moment looks most likely to be the Cambridge Kodiaks, a brand new team as well. And it's gone to 96, Hayley Batsford-Carrington, who did look bright down at the right wing. Good for her. And, say, impressive young player. Did cause the Beacons plenty of problems, particularly with her pace. So, very well done to Hayley. And it's gone to 54, Claire Wilson, who battled hard going forward all game. Very well done and well deserved to her. Well, that brings our broadcast to a close then for this one. We are back on air next weekend when the Beacons elite team take on the Streatham Storm. Please do tune in for that one, and we'll be seeing you all then. But in the meantime, thank you and good afternoon.